Shotgun snap for Romo. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Second down now after the incompletion.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. 23 yards on the play. So here we go, first and 10 now. On first down, it's Romo. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. They get 25 yards out of that one. And that leads to a Chicago first down. Now Tony Romo on first down. Throwing right, and that's complete. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And it'll be a Chicago first down. And now they're in the hurry up. On first down, Romo. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Mike Wallace, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
This will be caught inside the 10. And stacked a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. And they're going to speed things up here. To the air again. Romo steps away to his left.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it turned into an exceptional run. What a scramble for a touchdown.
So they're going to go for 2. Romo going to throw for it. Dancing to his left. And he will get into the end zone, and the 2-point conversion will cut this down to a 6-point game. Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send this one away. This one taken from the 7. Able to get away.
He's going to keep the legs churning.
Return there as he's up to the 35, but make it the 40-yard line.
And that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. That last drive, it was a good mix. One pass, one pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit with play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. They'll run again with Bernard. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one. He's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Alert! Alert! 3 out of 20!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Back-to-back one-yard runs here, so that leaves him with a 3rd down and 8. And 3rd quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you stop the clock and you've helped it.
Under heavy pressure, and down goes Dalton on the sand. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to have the offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
It'll be a 44-yard punt. The return goes for 8. And the offense will come back onto the field for the 1st and 10. Now the Bengals defense readies as they head onto the field. And in a tight ball game like this, the defense looking for a stop. If whether you're the offense or the defense, you don't want to be the one to screw this thing up.
No, not at all. And right now, you've got to figure that the offense is thinking to themselves, if you just get us the ball, we'll make things happen for you. Just help us out a little bit. And that's what the defense has to have in mind as they try it out here for this series.
Yeah, right now the offense on the sideline. Can the defense do it? Back now in Cincinnati, as we are just about set to go here in quarter number four. So the offense has it first and 10. They pitch it out to Anderson. A strong running. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 10 yards on the pickup there. And that leads to a Chicago first down.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offensive linemen do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is that they can run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to bring up a 3rd and about 7 left.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes, it's not a very successful play.
A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. And leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense. Out of the gun, Romo escaping the pressure right. Incomplete. His big tight end, Tyler Eifert, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the two-minute warning.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks in.
Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And they have taken the lead here in this fourth quarter. So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. The defense once more getting set to do battle as they head back out. And everything's going to rest on this drive. Can they keep them out of field goal range? Because a field goal would win it.
So now you're in that position that you can't just back off and give them easy throws. At the same time, you don't want to press them so hard they go over the top and beat you deep. So you're playing a tight defense with an idea that you have the lead. Whatever you do, don't let them in the field goal range and give that up.
Maybe tight, but not too tight.
Exactly. I mean, it's perfect, right? It's kind of like lacing up your shoes. Get it exactly right and no more.
See if they lace them right. Back to throw. He drops it off for Bernard. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 6 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. He'll look to throw. On the right side, caught by Green. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
They'll look to throw. Underneath, this is Bernard. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Second down now after the pass completion.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
He's back to throw. To the left side here for Eifert. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. And quickly, they get to the line. Back to throw. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Dalton. Complete to the right side. It's Eifert. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
And there's another conversion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it. Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Desperation throw deep downfield. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They're up by one. They have the football. The Chiefs here just don't do anything silly, right, Charles?
That's exactly right. You know, all the admonitions as they ran out there.
And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Romo going to throw it. Wide open is Watkins. He's got him. And now the Bengals are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Romo now throw. Again, that's Watkins. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course, you've got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. In a great spot. It's first and goal from the three. And he's across for the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game.
And that touchdown puts him up seven. But now's when the fun begins, partner, because if you go and kick the extra point, it's still a one-possession game. Go for two, you might put it out of reach.
Yeah, a little decision to be made. Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send this one away. This fielded at the two. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos, follow me on social media, and once again, thanks for watching.